Rev up your engines! Today I'm going to talk about old Volvo station wagons. This one's 13 years old, when they used to still build them solid, unlike the more modern ones. This 2007 XC70 is one of the last decent cars that Volvo ever made. Realize that the Chinese own Volvo now. And they say that they're going to concentrate on building just electric cars or hybrid electric cars. No more of these gasoline engines that made Volvo famous. So this one's just a baby with a little less than 200,000 miles. In short, it's typical Volvo, the leather seats all ripped and the plastic crap is all breaking off, but it still runs pretty good. It being a station wagon, you can put all kinds of crap in it. You can see there's all kinds of crap in this one already. Now this particular one is a 5-cylinder turbo, and it puts out 236 foot-pounds of torque for pulling and acceleration at only 1500 RPM. Takes off really fast for a relatively heavy wagon. And talk about solid, this particular one was parked outside my garage here. About a year and a half ago, there's an Alcoholics Anonymous down the street, and a woman came out in her Infiniti SUV, proceeded to smash into the thing. I felt my whole house shudder. Then behind my garage, right here in the middle of the street, her Infiniti SUV was sitting with the right front axle broken completely off and her bumper torn off and lying in the street. I said, you just ran into my customer's car, and the woman said, I didn't run into anything. I said, yeah, the only reason you're here is because your axle fell off and the front bumper fell off. You couldn't drive the car anymore. You tried, but all the fluid came out of the transmission. She ended up having to pay my customer money because of course she didn't have any insurance. Well, she claimed she did, but she didn't want to put it on the insurance. But she gave my customer cash. But look at the Volvo. See these little scratches on the plastic side? That's basically all that happened to the Volvo. When you look at it from here, it just looks like dirt. There was this Infiniti SUV, big giant thing, sitting in the street, completely demolished, from smashing into this Volvo. And the only thing it did to the Volvo was damage some of the plastic on the fender well. There's no arguing. This is a well-built, safe vehicle. Just listen to the door when it shuts. Look at this. One solid car. Now, being big, heavy cars, they do have a disadvantage. This thing is pretty much a gas hog in town, and the best you're ever going to get on a highway is maybe 25 miles a gallon. But these old station wagons, these things just can go and go with bare maintenance on them. And of course, they have a tremendous amount of space. We look around here, it's big, got a nice trunk. And of course, for those family vacations, got the classic roof rack. You can put even more crap on the top if you're going to Disney World. A strong front and rear disc brakes. And even this old one's got airbags all over the place. Volvos were one of the big innovators in safety. And they sold enough of them that parts, no big deal these days. At least in the United States where I live, I get parts for these things readily all over the place. They sold enough of them that getting parts is not a pain like with a Fiat or say a Porsche or a BMW. They are better priced and you can get a lot of aftermarket stuff for them. A lot of people love these things, so there's a big aftermarket for them. You look down here, it's got a Japanese air conditioning compressor on it. This baby keeps you nice and cool. It's got a lot of cold air. Now the early Volvos, yeah, whew, they stunk. I mean, a lot of guys tried to put bigger fans to make them blow harder and stuff. Not on this. This thing's got a great air conditioning system. Let's just say a hot day in Sweden is equivalent to a cold day in winter in Houston, Texas. So they did iron out air conditioning in these things a long time ago. Not many people often say about Volvos, you either love them or you hate them. But hey, you gotta see, this isn't as boxy as the older ones. It's got a lot more style to it than the old totally boxy Volvos that the Swedes made for ages. It still retains the basic shape of the older square Volvos, but they're rounded out more, and they really are much more stylish than those old ones that they sold in the 70s and the early 80s. Now me, when I was young, we grew up with station wagons. If they would have had a station wagon as reliable like this when I was a kid, I'm sure people would have flocked from all around to buy them. But of course now SUVs are taking over the market. I do have to say though, the old Volvo station wagons, take whatever you can throw at them and still go rolling down the road. Look at this one. It got smacked so hard the other car, the front, broke right off, and all it got was a little scratch on the side. So if you were wondering why I used to see a whole bunch of Volvo station wagons around, now you know, they were pretty solid built vehicles. Sadly, but truly, they don't make them anymore though. And that's a real shame, but hey, there's still a whole bunch of old ones still rolling around. Maybe fix it up a little and drive the heck out of it. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.